in no way, shape, or form is cow's milk a health food. We don't need milk to be healthy. We don't need milk to perform. If we choose to use milk in that way, the long-term adverse health consequences of that far outweigh whatever perceived benefit you're going to get in the short run. I'm Dr. James Loomis, and I'm the medical director at the Barnard Medical Center, which is run by the Physicians Committee for Responsible Medicine in Washington, D.C. I had the distinct privilege to be the team doctor, the St. Louis Rams football team and the St. Louis Cardinals baseball team, and was fortunate enough to be with those teams. Went to 2 Super Bowls and 2 World Series, so I actually own a World Series ring and a Super Bowl ring. Cow's milk has been associated with a wide range of chronic problems, breast cancer, colon cancer, heart disease, inflammatory bowel disease like Crohn's disease, but also allergies and asthma. And we stop drinking milk if a lot of times people, you know, you exercise and you don't even realize, you don't know what it's like. If you've been drinking milk your whole life, you don't know, even know what it's like to breathe better, breathe normal, because your performance has always been impaired. And that happened to me. I expected to lose weight. I expected my cholesterol to go down. I expected my sleep apnea to get better. But what I didn't expect is my exercise-induced asthma and my allergies to go away, and they did. I think we just need to educate people the health consequences of dairy consumption, but not only individuals, we need to educate physicians, we need to educate dietitians, we need to educate coaches and trainers. It is a kind of a daunting task, but I see hope. We forget eating is a learned behavior, and that's what makes change so hard. If we've learned that milk is healthful, And we have cereal in the morning and the learned behaviors to pour milk on it. You know, it's hard to change that. But driving is another example of a learned behavior. And if you moved to London from the United States, you'd have to learn how to drive on the other side of the street. And every day you got in that car for the first few months, you got to think about what side of the road am I on and what side of the pedestrian's coming from. So switch for good means you got to teach yourself how to drive on the other side of the road and drive that way for the rest of your life. I'm proud to be dairy-free, and I'm proud to share that message with my patients.